What's going on, everyone? I thought I'd take the time and make this video. You know, everybody gets haters every now and then, whatnot. But I wanted to show this Louis bag because some of the material that I use, you know, people tell me that it's fake or whatever. So I thought I'd make this video just to shut those assholes up. So basically, this is a Louis tote bag. Okay? Now, this bag, if people don't know about Louis, if you really want to know Louis, when you walk in a store to tell the difference between a fake Louis and a real Louis is, one way is look at the patterns where the stitch, see the stitch right here? When they sewed it down the middle, they matched up the symbols. Notice, look at these two, look at these two. Okay, that's one way of looking at it. Two, if you know about leather, you could tell real leather from pleather, plastic mixed with leather. Okay, and three, let's go on inside, even though this is all gutted out. You ever see the little chain that comes in it? Yeah, well, here's a serial number. Go ahead, go on the Louis Vuitton site, run this number. I bet you'll come through. Two, the zippers, they're high quality, if you want to look at it. And plus, it comes stamped with the original Louis Vuitton. That's two. Three, the stitching. If you notice, it's a yellow stitching that has a slanted, let me see, it's not focusing, stitch to it. Here, let me show you one from the outside. Maybe it's a little bit easier. See it? Focus. There it is. It has like a little slight slant to it. And then the mahogany straps. This bag has been used. This bag has been has a little wear on it, as you can tell right here. But look at the mahogany straps. They still look brand new. That's why you pay for quality. So if anybody says fake or not, I'm about to cut this one up. Here's my scalpel. It's a long process, but I'm gonna cut it here and then I'll probably do another clip either while I'm doing it or as soon as I'm finished doing it. I gotta go through every stitch so I can save as much of the skin as possible so I can use it for using material. So I thought I'd share this with you guys. Much love, everyone. All right, so made the first cut. Again, just in case for the social media police. Same number. I want you to think it's a different bag. Once you break the stitch, then it becomes easy after that. You just start ripping it away. And as you can tell, their string is pretty thick and a distinctive gold color. It's very hard to find the same color. So basically, once you make the first incision, it should be easily just peeling off. But it's just a process where you just gotta go slowly but surely, because each part is a stitch and there's so many stitches in it. So pull, rip, pull, rip. So I thought I'd show you guys, here's the beginning process of it. So about 15 minutes in, we got this little pile of garbage. All we did was just get the top part. Shows you how many stitches are in there. And then when you finally get it out, there's the inner liner. This is just an inner liner. And then the buckle that holds this buckle is right there. And then look at all the stitching. They're literally glued onto each other. Like back to back. So you gotta go in there with the knife and pop every stitch in order to peel it off without destroying the outer part. Thought I'd share that with you guys, but here's the inner liner. You just keep peeling around. There it is. See their glue? That's from them. This is from the Louis. Last time somebody seen this was when the Louis was making it. Now you see these little pouches? This is the pockets inside the purse. There's a zipper. And there's the Louis tag stitched in the back. Thought I'd share with you guys. So don't throw this away. We still want to get this leather out of there. Plus you got the print and you got the number in there. So now we're moving the tags. There was the buckle that was held in here, as you could tell. And now it's like a domino effect. You pull, stitches come out, it stops. Run your X-Acto, be careful, the X-Acto is super sharp. Strip it a little bit, and then it pulls out, gets stuck again. Cut, 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 cut. Pull, cut, cut. I don't think you guys could see it. And then pull. And it's just a long process. All this gets cleaned up. The holes, obviously those are garbage. But we get to save as much material as we possibly can. So we got to do this all the way around. Alright, so an hour into it, we got the inner bag out, we got the top trim off with the straps, very clean straps, they are resellable, especially on eBay or Amazon, people look for these things. The straps, depending on how they are and the condition, it varies, it can go from 75 to like a fair quality. To actually a very clean quality up to about 150, maybe sometimes even 200, depending on how clean they are. This, I want to say they're probably about 100. There's only one spot right here. There's like a little stain on it. But everything else is clean. I mean, super clean. So I'll say they're probably worth about $100. And believe me, there's a lot of people out there. The zippers, the labels, whatever, the straps, they want them. So, we got the straps. I'm probably going to go ahead and attack the pockets and the little stamps and the stuff inside the bag. And then I'm going to come back and get the bottom piece off. But everything else is off. All this part right here in the middle, this is dead. This is completely dead because of the glue. They put industrial strength glue. So it's on both sides. So basically, there goes about 10% of the bag. So when you say, why are they so expensive? Because the bags are expensive. You're limited to X amount of material per bag. And then you got your labor. So let's see the next update. All right, so we did the inside of the purse. Here's the Louis tag with the number. You see it? There's a little gold link that comes in there. We also got the zipper with the Louis logo on it. Needs to be cleaned up a little bit. And the Louis frame on the wallet where it has a Louis print on it. I don't know if you can see that. There it is. Just needs to be cleaned up a little bit. Now, we're working on the bottom. So basically what you do is you make an incision, cut off the little stitching, start pulling it up, go down the base, and as you go, you'll get stuck, hit it, pull down, in there. And there's the bottom of your Louis bag. Let me get that off for you guys. Hold on. Off camera. Oh, I need a couple more stitches on the side. You gotta be very careful with the X-Acto knife. There you go. And we pull this out. Oh. Oh, they got, I forgot about that. They got right here the clamps. If you take this off, it's what's holding the bottom together. So they're literally like little clamps. They're like spider webbed. They bend wide so they can hang in there. So basically I gotta take off this piece of tape and cut it out. So I thought I'd show it to you guys. But we're almost done. Wait, can't even see it. We're almost done. This is the last part. So all this glue and whatever, the trim, all this is gonna be cut out, thrown in the garbage. The good stuff is only gonna be kept. Show you the next step. All right, you guys, so we got down to the bottom. Remove the tapes where they were. And I realized I didn't show it to you guys. So you take anything sharp, I got a pair of scissors. You pin it, you give it a little bend, enough to get the scissors in there. Lift up, and right underneath the bottom, give it a little twist, and it just sinks right through. There you have it. Focus. There it is. Usually it's rubbed on the ground, put on the ground, whatever the case may be. So there's four of them. And then here's the board, which they put a little adhesive on the back. There it is. Piece of cardboard. Cheap cardboard. Toss it to the side. Four flimsy pins. When you're in pain, only for the name. Remember that. So, there's the final piece. I just gotta get this trim off. And then this is the piece that we got left. And you gotta remember the holes, no good. We can't use these. So there's like four different spots. Whatever we could salvage in between, we could. Now, other than the bottom piece I just showed you, and I trimmed up, this is what I salvaged. Here's one. Here's two. That has a little damage on it, so that's no good. Here's three. Here's four. Like I remember, they're long, but they're not that wide. And here's the final one. You get a swoosh on a Nike Air Force. Maybe the tongue part or the back part. But really, you guys, you can't get that many pairs of shoes off of one bag. And the tote's actually the biggest one. So I thought I'd share this with you guys. Remember, quality, time, and this ain't cheap. So when you complain, oh, they're too high, the prices are that's not my problem. Call Louis, tell them to lower their prices, or Gucci, and then we can talk about it. For the meantime, yeah. You got to bill out the fraction of what the cost plus the labor. It is what it is. Much love. Stay safe. Be prepared. And remember, united. Peace. I'm listening, niggas, that they hate it, I ain't change up. They see me hustling, trying to run and get this change up. But that's just solid, so no more doing them favors. When they see me, I be ganked up. A lot of niggas, that they hate it, I ain't change up. They see me hustling, trying to run and get this change up. But that's just solid, so no more doing them favors. I did a lot for the people, but they ain't do it for me. You know them times that I waited, but they were ducking from me. They let me off for the payment, but now they see that I flee. They see a youngin' get money, and now they own. Wanna be it, man, they see in the video, they be knowing it's me, but they be knowing I'm a stereo when I play with the beat, man, now you hear me on stereos when they pull on the scene, now you hear me on stereos when you pull on the scene, when they see me, I be ganked up, a lot of niggas that they hate it, I ain't changed up, they see me hustling, trying to run and get this change up, but that's just all it's no more doing the but that's just all it's no more doing the favors, when they see me, I be ganked up, a lot of niggas that they hate it, I ain't changed up, they see me hustling, trying to run and get this change up, but that's just
that's all I said, no more doing them favors. I did a lot for the people, but they ain't do it for me. You know the time that I waited, but they were ducking from me. They let me off for the payment, but now they see that I flee. They see a youngin' get money, and now they all wanna beat him. And they seein' them videos, they be knowing it's me. But they be knowing I'm a stereo when I play with the beam. And now you hear me on stereos when they pull on the scene. Now you hear me on stereos when you pull on the scene. When they see me, I be ganked up. A lot of niggas that ain't hated, I ain't changed up. They see me hustling, tryna run and get the change up. But that's the solace, and no more doing them favors. When they see me, I be ganked up. A lot of niggas that ain't hated, I ain't changed up.